Hello everyone, I'm Carmen Rodriguez-Peralta. I'd like to welcome you to the World of Music Concert Series. This is our third concert in our fall series of live recordings. We are thrilled to be presenting and welcoming again with wonderful guitarist Jerome Mouffe. He has a very colorful program prepared, which will explore the reciprocal influences between music from the old and the new world. I know you'll enjoy his program.
Good evening, everybody. It's a pleasure to be here in the concert hall of the Bedford campus of Middlesex Community College. I want to thank Carmen Peralta for making this possible, along with the fantastic crew of the Bedford TV. It's great to bring you this program that was meant to be performed originally in May. And of course, as we all know, this was not possible at the time. So here we are, fortunately, in the concert hall, bringing this music, hopefully, that will find you safe and healthy in your living rooms or wherever you get to enjoy it. The program that you will hear today is called Ida y Vuelta. This is the idea of a return journey between of influences, reciprocal influences, between different composers, between the old continent and the New World, more specifically, Latin America. The piece that you just heard is called Una Limosna por el Amor de Dios by Agustin Barrios. Barrios was a guitar virtuoso of his own himself, and he was also a very important composer for us guitarists. And the piece that you heard was actually the very last that he composed. For that reason, it's sometimes called also El Último Tremolo, the last tremolo, which is the technique that you heard here on the right hand of all these repeated notes that give that continuity in the melodic line. And it's also called sometimes La Última Canción. Barrios composed in two different styles, the traditional classical style, and also a lot of his work are influenced by folk music from Latin America. In this program, you'll actually hear a little bit of both. But I would like to continue with another piece by him that's called Mazurka Apasionata. It's a passionate mazurka. And of course, as you can all imagine, in this piece, you will hear some influence by a great composer who was an influence on him, and that is, of course, Frédéric Chopin. Thank you. That was Agustin Barrio's Mazurka Appassionata, and it was in the classical style of his composition. Barrios was fascinated by some of the great composers from the old continent, and Chopin was one of them. Paganini was another one. He liked to call himself, actually, the Paganini of the guitar from the jungles of Paraguay. He was quite a character. He was also a real virtuoso on the guitar. And another composer that he really enjoyed was Robert Schumann. And so much so that he arranged his Schumann's beautiful Traumerei from the Kinderszenen for guitar in one of the most successful arrangements that I think exist. He's done that with the low E string tuned down to a low C, so two full step down, and the fifth string tuned down to a G, changing the key from F originally to C. I will pair that Traumerei, actually I will precede it, with my own arrangement of the last scene from the set by Schumann, which is Der Dichter spricht. Thank you. And to conclude this set, I would like to play one last piece by Agustin Barrios, and that one is called Choro da Saudade. And this is a choro, so it's a piece that was influenced by Brazil and the neighboring country for him, and also a country he got to visit several times. This is Barrios' own version of that, with a bit of a melancholic tune to that, with the theme of saudade, which is a very untranslatable term, but for all people who speak Portuguese out there, I know it will speak to them. The closest it gets, it's a mix of nostalgia, melancholy, something like that. We'll continue with a set of three waltzes by Venezuelan composer Antonio Lauro. And these, of course, are influenced by the traditional form of the waltz from the old continent, but you will see and hear, I think, that they also heavily reflect the rhythmical influences of Latin America, and in this case, the music of Venezuela. These were made to fit the instrument, the guitar in this case, by the great Venezuelan guitarist Alirio Diaz. So these are his version and edition of the three waltzes. The first one is called El Maravino, then it's waltz number two and number three. We are headed to Brazil, with a fantastic and a very well-known composer, Heitor Villa-Lobos, who was a composer but was also a cellist. And as it turns out, he also played the guitar quite very well. Fortunately for us guitarists, that means that he composed several sets of very beautiful music for us. One of them is a set of 12 etudes, which are really concert etudes. They are very demanding on the guitar. And there's also a set of five beautiful preludes, as well as a bunch of music that is influenced by, again, folk music from Brazil, in that case. And I will play for you one in each of the two genres, the prelude, which is in the more classical style. That's his prelude number two. And then I'll follow that with his choro number one. Thank you. The following piece borrows from a very different tradition. It's the tradition of flamenco. Flamenco is the folk music from Spain, more particularly developed in the south part of Spain, Andalusia. And this particular piece, though, I chose it this program because it very well reflects the theme. It's actually a palo. Palo is a style of flamenco, so this is a palo that they call palo de ida y vuelta. Why? Because it's a guajira. And the guajira is one of the styles in flamenco, but it actually comes from the New World. In this case, it originated in Cuba. And so you can see how return journey can really go both ways and influence back, in this case, European Spanish traditional folk music, enriching it with new rhythms, in this case, the rhythm of the guajira. This specific guajira was composed, if we could say, flamenco is an oral tradition, so more created by the great guitarist Paco de Lucía. So this is his Guajira de Lucía. And I'd like to finish this program today with a couple of pieces that are tangos. The first one is by the famed composer Astor Piazzolla, who went to study composition under Nadia Boulanger in Paris Conservatoire, and she actually encouraged him to compose using the idioms from his country, Argentina. And this is what gave birth to the Tango Nuevo and Piazzolla's myriad of fantastic compositions, mainly for his own quintet that was made of bandoneon, his own instrument, like a small accordion, one guitar, a double bass, a violin, and a piano. He composed also some other pieces for smaller combinations, but that was the bulk of his composition. And this is actually an interesting arrangement that I'm about to play because it was arranged for solo guitar from the quintet version, so a lot of notes to fit on just one guitar, but it was made by his own guitarist who played with him in the quintet, Baltasar Benitez. So that's his arrangement of Verano Porteño. Thank you. And to conclude, this is the very famous tango, La Comparsita, by Gerardo Matos Rodriguez. And this is actually an arrangement that I like very much by Juanjo Dominguez, great guitarist from Argentina. And I remember hearing his arrangement for the first time on the CD back home in Belgium at the time, and I just paused everything. I was like, I gotta play this. So I looked for the score, and of course there was no score. So I was left with a dilemma, either not learning the piece, which really wasn't an option, so I had to learn it by ear. And that's what I did. Now there's a lot of techniques, as you will see, that are quite unusual in that piece, and so it was not easy to get it by ear, but eventually I did, and it's been a really fantastic piece that I've enjoyed playing for ever since. Mm-hmm.